Hey there, welcome to Truth Bombs. I grew up watching a lot of television and my head is frankly filled with a lot of stories. But there came a time when Indian television and the content on Indian television stopped making sense to me, barring a few stories that fought against the tide. Our guest today is author, scriptwriter and awesome person Gajra Kottary. Gajra started out as a journalist with The Statesman, and she first shot into prominence in 1996 with her book Fragile Victories. She is the scriptwriter for long-running shows such as Balika Vadhu, Astitva and Silsila Badalte Rishton Ka. Please welcome Gajra Kottary on this episode of Truth Bombs. Welcome to Truth Bombs, Gajra. It is great having you with us today. And you have been instrumental in writing so many interesting stories with women in center, and it has been great watching them unfold on screen, especially with Balika Vadhu.
Thank you so much for having me.
So, Balika Vadhu was a show that showed the entire arc of a girl's life, especially dealing with the sensitive issue that it did with regards to child marriage. And it showed the entire arc from her growing up, including her coming of age and reaching puberty. So what was the thought process behind that scene? What happened on set that day? And
Well, you know, exploring the world of the girl child was basically how we went about treating Balika Vadhu as a story. So it was very organic in the sense that all the things that are likely to happen to a young girl who is just her chirpy, normal, energetic, witty self and is thrown into this very strange and bizarre situation for her age. So all the things, the milestones of her life, vis-a-vis continuing studies, her role in the house, the amount of work she's expected to do or not to do. So we tried exploring all that, and then after about 6-7 months, I think this was early 2009, a good 10 years now, when we felt that she was ready to sort of move into that next stage. This would be the most normal thing to happen to her. And you know, Avika was always a very intelligent actress. Beyond the sort of briefing that she got in the early days and weeks, she pretty much got the sense of whatever she was expected to perform, and she did a brilliant job. However, when it came to this, you know, our decision to show the menstruation, the first menses of a girl, the biggest dilemma was that we didn't know whether she actually knew what it was all about. So we did a kind of a pre-shoot meeting where we actually spoke to her mother, and that's exactly what we had kind of feared, that the girl did not know what it was all about, and it was because she had to perform the scene that all of us together kind of explained to her what menstruation was.
Okay.
So having understood that, she did a brilliant job. The thought here was, you know, the first period of a young girl is a time when she's very vulnerable. No matter that she has been prepared for it, or in most cases, frankly, not prepared for it, she needs her mother. She just wants to go and hug her mother, and her mother should be able to tell her that, look, little girl, this is normal, this is fine, nothing's wrong, and it's going to be okay. So that that privilege not being available to a young girl where she's in her in-law's house,
right,
is possibly was a very, very emotionally fraught situation for us to deal with. And while her mother-in-law was like a mother to her, she herself was in a sense being controlled by her mother-in-law. And therefore this little girl had to follow all those obnoxious sort of rules of the household, which included sleeping on the ground and not entering the kitchen and generally being made to feel that she was dirty.
So there is this popular misconception that all these things that we spoke about, including child marriage, happens only in rural India or doesn't happen to where we live or around us.
Yeah. Well, it definitely happens more in the rural areas. But I think if you just extend the definition of child marriage, I mean, a girl at 17, 18, according to me, is still a child. She's not mature enough to handle something as huge as marriage, because as Anandi discovered, it's not about good food and dressing up and all those exciting things happening to you and you being the center of attention. So that's something, unfortunately, even our city girls at 17 and 18, there are lots of families who believe in getting them married really early. So there was a very, very logical reason why Balika Vadhu did well even in the cities, because emotionally people connected with what was happening to Anandi. It was not just okay because it was a well-made serial, but it was also because they related to what was happening.
Right. So Balika Vadhu was one of the first TV shows to show menstruation on Indian television. Was that a difficult decision for the channel and for you?
Right. For us, it was not. For the team, it was not a difficult decision. It was slightly difficult for the channel because, 10 years ago, menstruation was much more of a taboo subject than what it is today. Today, at least, it's coming out a little. It's and after Padman, it's really opened up the whole talk about menstruation. So it was slightly difficult to convince the channel, but they had a lot of faith in us that, you know, it wouldn't be something which we would show in a very sensational, needlessly sensational light. You know, the idea is not to show blood and gore or talk about blood and gore. The idea is to talk about the issue. The idea is to treat it normally, to sort of explore what happens to it as a phenomena and as to the human being it's affecting. So once the channel was convinced that we would treat it sensitively, they were totally with us on this. Yeah.
So in the last 10 years since Balika Vadhu, how has the issue of menstruation been shown differently on television or on Indian media or even ads?
I think the ads have really opened up a lot of things. They have connected, in fact, menstruation with the fact that it need not hamper you from achieving your dreams or, you know, continuing with as normal a life as possible. I think that's where the ads have changed. They were, you know, sanitary napkins were always being advertised, but the tone of the ads has changed for the better, I feel. Unfortunately, I feel apart from a Padman, which was a complete movie based on someone who decided something about the issue. Apart from the movie itself, there is a kind of conspiracy of silence. So there is, it's actually never referred to or touched upon. And I'm just glad that social media is bringing it out very interestingly. You know, I saw this video of Garliapa where they were talking about periods and in a sense laughing about it and just trying to tell women that, okay, it's cool, sometimes it's irritating, but treat it as a natural phenomenon. We are not ill, we are not dirty. So that is nice. On the other hand, there are a lot of things which I've seen where the men are sort of scoffing, making fun. There is comedy around a woman having her periods, whether it's in terms of her moods or the way she dresses. That's not fine.
So what is the one thing that you think men should know about the situation?
Much the same as what women frankly need to know, that neither is it a dark, gloomy and horrific process. There may be some medical issues associated with it. Those need to be addressed and openly at that. Nor is it something where you just, you know, crack those jokes at the workplace or even at home for that matter, that oh, she must be chumming, that's why, you know, she's behaving this way. I mean, that I think is the worst thing that men can do and women can stay silent about.
Right.
That's not on. So I'm actually really, really glad that 10 years after we did this in Balika, I see the environment has changed a lot, yet a lot of it needs to translate in the media. For sure, that's not enough.
So, we were browsing through some of the online forums that were discussing Balika Vadhu, and there were comments which called this particular scene disgusting, and there were also people who said, come on, it's natural, it's regular. So what was the audience reaction in 10 years back?
Much the same as what social media reflected at that time, that some people felt they were squirming, they were not liking the fact that it was touched upon. There were some who of course were very praiseworthy that we had at least dared to touch something which wasn't being addressed anywhere. It was like a, you know, elephant in the room for most people in real life as well as real life. We kind of analyzed that the reason for people to feel this way was because it was a family show. And when they would all be sitting together, our timing was 8 o'clock, which is also when entire family sat to watch the show. So perhaps the elders were afraid of young children asking them questions. So we had debated this and we felt that yes, this is exactly what we want, because it should. Parents who sometimes shy away from addressing the issue on time will perhaps have to address the issue in the best way possible, and this will possibly save a lot of children from the horror of, you know, possibly thinking that, you know, they are dying, because that's what has been across the board the reaction of most girls who have not been told that at a certain age they are going to menstruate. They all think that they are going to die, and it's nowhere close to that. They just need to be told things are fine.
Right. Growing up in India, what is the most ridiculous myth that you were told?
Mm-hmm. I loved ice cream, so I was told that if I have ice cream when I'm chumming, then it's going to hurt more. So typically, like all kids, when they're banned from something, they want to try it out. I tried it out several times. It didn't hurt me any more than it had been hurting me previously. So I continued to have my ice cream.
Thank you, Gajra, for sharing your thoughts with us. We have this fun section called the Rapid Fire. So I have these quick questions which I'd like you to answer in short.
Now I'm getting scared.
So the first question is, from the three of your serials or your TV shows, some of which were long running, which is your favorite? So one is Astitva, Balika Vadhu, or your new serial Silsila?
My all-time favorite has actually been Astitva. It was the first of its kind, very bold in its concept, and it was almost magical because one didn't expect such a theme to go on for as long as it did. And people's reaction to it was refreshing because it was completely unexpected.
Which of the leading actresses from today would you like to play Simran from Once Upon a Star? Simran is a very complex character.
That's true. I would be really happy to have Vidya Balan play Simran, because I feel she brings that normalcy, that beauty, and she brings alive layers in her character very well. So she would be my choice.
Which characterization in Indian television today is more unjust? The mother-in-law or the daughter-in-law?
Mother-in-law. Yeah, we just love painting them unfair and demons, and but they have a point of view. I mean, they have a point of view, and we haven't done enough to bring that out, because it's a young people's medium, so we do more justice to the 18 to 35 magical group, which the mothers-in-law don't qualify to belong. Yeah.
That's interesting.
Hmm.
And which would be your next project? A web series or television in the future?
Well, I'm enjoying the very initial stages of some work I'm doing in web series. Because, you know, I've done a lot of long-running shows. So the very thought of doing something which is finite is so refreshing that, yes, I can actually think of a beginning, middle and end for my story and I don't have to keep it open-ended. So I'm enjoying that. At this point in my career, I'm looking forward more to that.
Thank you so much, Gajra, for joining us today on Truth Bombs and sharing your views on menstruation and your experiences with showing this taboo subject on television. It has been great having you and listening to your thoughts. So stay tuned for more of Truth Bombs and like, subscribe and share.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.